Yeah, good afternoon and welcome to Corporate Finance Online Classes. This is Dr. Mahesh M. Munjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. Okay. So dear students, let us begin the session with a micro presentation by Balappa. Okay. So I'll make Balappa the host now. So, Balappa, are you sharing something or just you are reading the...
No, sir. I just reading the news, sir.
Okay. Can you... turn on your video at least.
Sir, there is a network problem.
You
sir.
Try, let's see first. You try once. If it is very disturbing, you can turn off the video, okay?
Yes, sir, I'm trying, sir.
Okay, see Balappa, you have to heading, you have to read it out loud. Read it out loud. And loud but slow pace.
Yes, there is. Shall I start soon?
Yeah, please start.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Balappa. The heading of the news that I am going to present today is Sensex rises 226.2 to hit fresh closing high. Nifty settles above 15,850. Source, I have taken the Times of India website, date 25th June 2008. Equity indices surged to record highs on Friday with the benchmark BSE Sensex rising over 200 points gains in banking, metal and financial stocks.
Okay, Balappa, please wait. Balappa.
Yes.
Okay, yes, you can turn off the video. Let's hear your audio.
No, sir.
Turn off your video.
Yeah, sir. Just off, sir.
Okay, now you read.
Sir.
Yes.
The 30 share BSE index to close at a press peak of 52,925, while the broader NSE Nifty settled 73 points or 0.46% at record of 15,863. Tata Steel, Axis Bank, ICICI Bank, Bajaj Finance and Maruti were the top gainers in the Sensex peak, rising as much as 4.68%. While Reliance, HUL, NTPC, Titan, Asian Paints and Bajaj Auto were the major losers, falling up to 2.23%. On the NSE platform, sub-indices Nifty, Metal Bank, PSU Bank and Financial Service gained as much as 2.71%. Overall, markets have done fairly well and for the second quarter. India is the best performing market across the Asian region. Amit Shah, head of the India equity research at BNP Paribas, told news agency Reuters. Investors are now waiting for some new data points. And in the meantime, the market will see sector rotation and individual stock picking, he added. Meanwhile, foreign institutional investors were net sellers in the capital market as they offloaded shares worth ₹2,890.94 crore on Thursday as per provisional exchange data. Now I am going to analyze this news. Sensex, which stands for Stock Exchange Sensitive Index, is the stock market index for the Bombay Stock Exchange. It calculates the movement on BSE. The rise in BSE market capital came after Sensex hit record high of 52,925, rose 226 points from previous. Overall market has done fairly well, and for the second quarter, India is the first performing market across the Asia region.
Okay, completed.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
So we can understand the poor connectivity. It is showing network bandwidth is low from your end, but anyway you made an attempt. Okay, so it's good to keep it up. Okay, next time onwards, students, you can scan the news, okay, or take a photo, edit it, crop it properly, and you can share that, and then you can read the news so that even the audience get to see the news. If your voice is breaking, we can see the text in the scan. Okay, other students, I'm telling.
Okay, sir.
Whose presentation is tomorrow? That student is present. You have to scan. If you are choosing a hard copy, you have to scan or take a photo. And if it is a soft copy itself, we can share it easily. Okay? Then you have to read.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Balappa. Okay. Thanks for updating us about the Bombay Stock Exchange. Okay. Now, students, let's get back to our regular. Okay. Procedure. So where, let me share you the PDF files. Yeah, please just give me a moment. Students, can you see the PDF file?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. So now let's solve, okay, another problem. Okay. Okay, so can you see this example, P.1.11.14?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah, so let's go ahead and solve this. So yeah, there are no twists in the problem, straightforward. Okay, but you have to use both, okay, book value weights as well as market value weights. Okay. In this example, a company has as its books the following amounts and specific costs of each type of capital. So this is the data given. Debt capital, book value 4 lakh rupees, market value 3,80,000 rupees. Now you already know what is the meaning of book value and market value. Cost of debt is 5%. So these things are readily given in the problem. Reference capital, book value 1 lakh rupees, market value 1,10,000 rupees. Cost of reference capital is 8%. Equity capital, book value 6 lakh rupees, market value 9 lakh rupees, and cost of equity capital is 15%. Okay, now only in this problem, okay. Retained earnings, they are given a specific cost which is separate from equity capital. Okay, you don't get confused. Just use what is given in the data. Though we have learned and understood that the cost of retained earnings is equal to the cost of equity capital. Okay, just for a change, the author has given some separate cost. So you need not bother much about it. You just go ahead with the data given in the problem. Retained earnings are book value 2 lakh rupees, market value 3 lakh rupees. So it is given in the problem, theoretical, just go ahead with it. Okay. The total book value 13 lakh rupees. Okay. So determine the weighted average cost of capital using book value weights and the market value weights. Okay. So we know the procedure, so it will be simple for us. So please pay attention. Weighted average cost of capital using book value weights. So column 1 is a type of capital, column 2 book value, column 3 specific costs, and column 4 is total cost in rupees of each source of finance. So yesterday Ruchita was asking, okay, can we take out the proportion column? Like yesterday it was 50%, 40%, okay. Ruchita, are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So here that column is not there. That column is not added here, proportions column, okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay. So let's go ahead with the simple calculations. Debt. Book value is 4 lakh rupees. And its cost is 5%. So which is 0.05. Simply you multiply 4 lakh into 0.05 to get the cost of debt capital, which is 20,000 rupees. Preference capital. Okay, book value is 1 lakh rupees. The cost of preference capital is 8%. So 1 lakh into 0.08 is equal to 8,000 rupees. Equity capital, 6 lakh rupees. Okay, the book value, cost of equity is 15%. So 0.15. 6 lakh into 0.15 is equal to 90,000 rupees is the cost of equity capital. Retained earnings, book value 2 lakh rupees. Okay, then specific costs, 13% as given in the problem, so 0.13. So 2 lakh into 0.13 is equal to 26,000. Okay, so book value, total of the column is 13 lakhs. Total cost is 1,44,000. So using the alternate formula, weighted average cost of capital KO is equal to total cost of capital 1,44,000 divided by total capital 13 lakhs into 100 to get that percentage. Okay, so it's equal to 11.07%. You can write both the digits, or you can just write 11.1%, the weighted average cost of capital using book value weights. There are no twists in the problem. Only thing is they have given, okay, two data, okay, which doesn't go ahead with the theory, what is given from the same author. One is like retained earnings, cost of retained earnings is always equal to cost of equity capital. The second thing is retained earnings, market value they have given, okay. You need not bother, you just go ahead with the data. So any questions here? Any questions? So was that simple? You are able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. So let's go ahead to the next part now. Second part of the determine the weighted average cost of capital using market value weights. Okay, so these are the market values. Debt 3,80,000, preference 1,10,000, equity 9 lakh, and retained earnings 3 lakh. We have to use these values now. That's it. Okay, procedure is same.
Sir.
Yes.
So how many marks you could contend for this sum?
This is simple, not 10 marks.
Okay, sir.
Okay, yes. See, it is there actually from old VTO question paper, old one. But most of the VTO question papers have taken problems directly from this textbook. This is the best textbook, okay? So in India for financial management, 10 marks. So this is actually example number in the 6th edition is a P.11.14. As it is without any change. Most of the problems are taken from the textbook, okay? And so we'll go ahead with the market value now. Yeah. So weighted average cost using market value weights. So type of capital is debt, market value, sorry, book value. 1 minute, huh? I think there is
market value.
Sorry. There is a, well, this word is wrong. It is not book value. Okay, please remember when you write this in your fair notebook, make it market value. Everyone, you heard me?
Yes, sir.
Since it is a PDF, I cannot correct it here, but I will correct it later. Huh? So you please rewrite it as market value. So debt, capital, market value, okay, is 3,80,000 rupees. And the cost of debt is 5%, we know, 0.05. So 3,80,000 into 0.05 is equal to 19,000 is the cost of debt in rupees. Preference capital, market value is 1,10,000 rupees. Cost of preference capital is 8%. So 1,10,000 into 0.08 is equal to 8,800 rupees. Equity market value is 9 lakh rupees. Cost of equity is 15%. So 9 lakh into 0.15 is equal to 1,35,000 rupees is cost of equity capital. Retained earnings market value is 3 lakh rupees. Cost of retained earnings is given as 13%. So 3 lakh, okay, into 0.13 is equal to 39,000. The total cost of this column is 2,01,800 and total capital is 16,90,000. So weighted average cost of capital, KO, is equal to total cost of capital, okay, which is 2,01,800 divided by total capital 16,90,000 into 100. If you simplify the answer, you get it 11.9%. Okay, 11.9% is the weighted average cost of capital using market value weights. And always remember, okay, market value weighted average cost of capital using market value weight is 11.9%, whereas weighted average cost of capital using book value weights is 11.1%. Okay, so please remember, because generally the market value of the securities will be more than its book value. Okay. Yes, especially equity shares. Okay, because the debt and preference cannot be said, but equity capital, usually their book market value. Okay, here, sorry. The market value of the equity shares will be generally greater than their book value. So those who have purchased equity shares of any company, they will understand. Remember this. Okay, at what price you buy, okay, or what is the face value, okay, the market price of the equity share will be generally greater than its face value. That is the reason why the weighted average cost of capital is higher, okay, when you use market value weights. And we have concluded that market value weights are the most, okay, appropriate or rational while computing weighted average cost of capital. Okay, so that's all about cost of capital, chapter number 11. So any general queries if you have related to this chapter, or any specific queries related to today's problem, you can ask. Or even in general, if you have any doubts related to financial management, stock market, you can ask. If I have clarity, I will provide you the answer. Okay, so this is the end of unit 3. Okay. Yeah, today I will give you the solutions to practice problems for unit 2, and also I will give you practice problems for unit 3 today. So first you have to check your answers for solutions to practice problems in unit 2, chapter number 9, capital budgeting evaluation techniques. If anything is wrong, you have to rewrite your solutions and answer. If it is correct, okay, you should be very happy. After that, you have to start solving problems on this chapter. Any doubts, any questions?
No,
okay, so Vedesh does not have any problem. Then other students, how about others?
No, sir.
Okay, Anushri says no.
No, sir.
Okay, good. So now, since unit is over, so the time is remaining. So I would like to tell you about tomorrow's agenda. Okay, so tomorrow it will be different. Okay. I will post a message in the WhatsApp group as well as in Google Classroom that tomorrow attendance will be compulsory for all 60 students. So there will be a quiz. Okay. So there will be a quiz on financial management. Okay. Even non-commerce students also, whatever you have learned in semester 1, accounting for managers, and whatever you have learned so far in corporate finance, I think that would be enough to answer the questions in the quiz. Okay, for this purpose, what I'm going to make is, if you can recall, I think I will make new teams. Okay, new teams. So now we don't have much time to go ahead with the choice of team. Simply it will be based on your roll numbers. Only you should have clarity of your roll number. So there will be total 10 teams, means each team will be of 6 members. Okay, and the team will be very simple. Roll number 1 to 6, team 1. Roll number 7 to 12, team 2. Roll number 13 to 18, team 3. This way, last team will be roll number 55, okay? 55, 56, 57, 58, 59, 60, yeah. Roll number 55 to 60 will be team number 10. Roll number 55 to 60 will be team number 10. Okay, you everyone please pay attention. If most of the teams really do well, if the average scoring, okay, there is scoring also, there will be timing, everything. If most of the teams score really well, let us say above 7 or 8, this will be one of your CTA components. That is the reason why attendance will be compulsory. Those who are absent, simply I'll put absent and they will get 0 marks if I consider this quiz as an assignment. You heard me?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.